going.
You need anything else, let me know.
Who would need a fake ID? Won't be anyone out here, would it?
I'm sorry, but I can't let you board the shuttle with that.
But this is a ceremonial item of my people!
Sir, it's a 15-centimeter serrated blade.
You humans are all racist!
Can I help you, ma'am?
Security seems heavy.
It's been a couple years since I passed through here. Security seems to have tightened a bit.
After the Geth attack, there was a review of security protocol. A few minor changes were made to reduce the risk of Geth infiltration. We apologize for the inconvenience.
You'd think a Geth would stand out.
Assumptions are dangerous. Be alert, be safe.
Thanks for your time.
Next!
There's no one next. Except maybe the Hanar. Residium? We can talk to Anderson. I don't think he needs a fake ID. So sad that this is the only place we can go to in the whole frickin' Presidium. Damn it. I want to explore! I want to walk with Elcor.
Something I can do for you, Shepard?
Have you been?
How've the last couple years treated you?
Well, he probably asked us already.
Serving on the Council isn't how I plan to spend my twilight years. Sometimes it feels like I'm just beating my head against a wall. Knowing the truth about Sovereign is brutal. It's nightmare stuff. I can't blame others for not wanting to believe it, but I know how important it is. So I keep trying. Fighting the good fight, right?
You should come with me.
Forget Udina and the Council. Join my crew and help me stop the Collectors.
I'm too old to go racing across the galaxy. Much as I complain, I've got an important job to do here. The front line. That's got to be yours.
Ashley Williams was on Horizon.
Right.
She said she was looking into Cerberus.
I know. I approved the mission. We had to find out if they were behind the missing colonists. I couldn't tell anyone without compromising the investigation. I'm sorry.
So you were spying on me?
I thought we were friends. Never expected you to go behind my back.
We didn't know about you at the time. And I wouldn't have told you if I did. What if the elusive man was manipulating you? Lying to you?
Got
the report actually confirmed your story. I still don't trust Cerberus. But they were right about the Collectors abducting the colonists. Unfortunately, Williams didn't find anything to convince the Council that the Reapers are behind this, or even that they exist.
I'm surprised no one can tell Sovereign isn't Geth technology. Didn't they examine the wreckage?
We don't have much to look at. Pieces of it rained all over the station. It was chaos, with who knows how many species combing the wards for their dead. We secured as much of it as we could. But between the Keepers and a whole lot of unauthorized salvage, there's no way to account for even half of that thing. Another reason why they don't want to acknowledge what Sovereign was.
Right.
Last I knew, we were still fighting holdouts.
Here and there. But they are increasingly disorganized. It's long since stopped being called a war. More like cleanup. Not that you can ever discount them. But we haven't had serious casualties for months. A civilian ship will spot an enclave, and we send in a squad to clear it. They're not quite the boogeymen they used to be.
How long did it take to get this place back up to speed after the battle?
Still counting. The main areas of commerce and the most populated wards are complete. But estimates for total restoration are sitting around 5 years. The Keepers always surprise us, though. It's like our repairs are annoying. We'll put up an ugly new bulkhead, and in a few days, they've made it seamless. We never really thought of them as heavy lifters, and I have no idea where they get the resources. But we'd never get done without them.
Yeah, I'm probably asked him all these questions already, except for the one for Ashley. That's gotta be new.
I better go.
My door is always open.
Well, thank you, old friend. 26. I'm not sure what level we came from. Need a fake ID?
You ever had ramen? It's a delicacy back on Earth.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store in the Citadel.
Ah, my favorite customer. What can I get you?
I'd like to buy something.
Oh, it's all automated these days. There's a catalog interface.
If everything's automated, why are you here?
Customer service. Carefully explaining things to the tech. It's stunning how many people think that light moves faster through expensive fiber optic cables than it does through cheap ones.
Thanks for your time.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Anything.
I'm Commander Shepard.
The nerve enhancement. Good day, citizen.
Yeah.
Welcome to the Serta Foundation.
I'm just browsing, thanks.
Come back soon, Shepard.
Come back, I'm Mick soon.
Tupari, now made with 10% real Tupo berry juice.
Anybody need some fake IDs? Or a fake ID? Ugh. I don't know where the hell to go for this crap. But I'll keep looking until I've looked everywhere.
Tupari is made with no natural sweeteners.
Great. No natural sweeteners. But unnatural sweeteners. Guess we're done here.
Mech attacks have increased as a programming malfunction virus spreads. Experts warn of the accompanying danger of poorly programmed security VIs being overzealous in protecting themselves from infection. A Synthetic Insights representative stressed that this is a standard VI processing error, not an indication of an AI threat similar to the Geth.
Gonna get you.
Greetings, Earth Clan. You will find many excellent ships for sale here. Only slightly used, yes.
Yes, yes. It's gotta be somebody here that. Galactic News. Kept wondering we have flashing on the screen there.
I can't believe these humans. No fly lists? What did they turn this place into? I overheard you talking. Having a problem?
Fly lists?
A human. Your kind is always shoving your way in to solve the galaxy's problems, aren't you?
If no one else will, yeah.
Look, little girl. When you need a problem shot, ask
or
a
that.
Man. When you need a problem talked to death, ask an Asari. When you need a new problem, ask a Salarian. When you want a problem fixed, ask a human.
I like that.
Like you fixed the council? If you'll excuse us, we don't want to talk with your kind.
Can we start over?
What do you want?
To apologize?
It seems I offended you. That wasn't my intention. Your attitude offends me. The smugness, the arrogance. All humans are like that since you let the Geth kill the real council. Now, the galaxy's in chaos. Pirates are striking in civilized clusters. Armed C-Sec officers are everywhere for our protection. And you swagger up to me, thump your chest, and tell me that only a human can solve my problems. Huh. Screw you.
Oh, damn. Tempted to do this. I might be able to help, though.
Look, miss. I personally did not make the pirates attack or post guards on every street corner. If you want help, I'll try to provide it. Otherwise, I'll go away. What do you have to lose by talking to me?
Fine.
Why are we talking
Since your kind took over the council, they've added new security checks and travel restrictions. All to keep us safe, they claim. We've been flagged as a potential risk for Geth infiltration. They won't let us board a ship back to Asari space.
Well, there's the forged IDs. Cool. Who should I talk to?
Who won't let you board a ship?
I don't know who made the decision. Some pencil pusher at the shuttleport told us. The one outside the C-Sec station?
Oh, the customs? C-Sec customs?
Why would they consider you a risk? You're obviously not Geth.
I don't know. They wouldn't tell us. We got on a list somewhere for some reason, and they won't tell us anything because it's classified.
Where was the IDs? It went away.
I'll see if I can get it sorted out.
I'm not holding my breath. What do you want?
Wait.
It seems I offended you. That
was your attitude. Offend? Now the galaxy's in chaos, and you swagger up to me. Thump your chest and...
Look, miss. If you want help, I'll try to provide it. Otherwise...
Fine. Since you're... We've been flagged as a potential risk for Geth infiltration.
IDs.
They won't let us board a ship back to Asari space.
Maybe these would work. They're new transit IDs.
You... How did you get those?
Doesn't matter.
If you don't want them, I could just take them back.
No, I'll take them. With thanks. We should get ready to leave. There should be another ship heading to Thessia tomorrow.
Experience. 1,000 credits. Okay. Cool. We found out. Who needed the IDs? Nice. Your rapid transit, I guess. I guess 26? Oh, wait. Current location. Wait a second. Yeah, we're right by C-Sec.
Yes?
Yeah, it's that girl.
I should be going.
You need anything else, let me know.
Since we gave her the IDs, I don't know if we have the option to talk to her, but might as well give it a try. On the way back anyway.
You'll have to wait for the next shuttle.
You made me miss the last one.
You needed to go through security.
Why are you treating me like a criminal?
Because you tried to bring a 15-centimeter serrated blade on a public shuttle.
You humans are all racist.
Can I help you, ma'am?
No option, just the same thing.
It's been a couple years since I passed through here.
After the Geth attack, there were a few minor changes were made.
Do you think a Geth would stand out?
Assumptions are dangerous. Be alert, be safe.
Thanks for your time.
Next.
All right. Done. Pretty sure we accomplished everything we were supposed to do here. And we've locked in two new members. With loyalty, anyway. I gotta have mail now.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Thank you. Thank you from my daughter, from Diana. Arya Talok told me where to send this. I'm Neff's mother. Oh yeah, I'm trying to look for you. I'm Neff's mother, Diana. We talked when you came to investigate her death. Arya also told me that a dead Asari woman was found in one of the wealthy apartments, that she was the one who'd killed my daughter. Thank you. I don't know who brought you into my life, but thank you for avenging my daughter. My Neff deserved better than this. I couldn't give it to her, but you at least killed the bitch who took what little she had away. Gratefully, Diana. So sad, though. Slip and sliding over there. We will check in on first fish, before I forget. Also, where do I get this VI? Fishies! Oh, sorry, fishies. Cool. Let's go back here. We gotta do these upgrades. Mucho importante. Muy importante. Weapon upgrades. Heavy pistol damage. Plus 30%. Heavy pistol critical. Heavy pistols sometimes deal double damage. Upgrade the heavy pistols and hand cannons of your entire squad. Normandy scientists have prototyped a modification to the traditional smart targeting module commonly incorporated into the high-end weaponry. While this technology is commonly used to compensate for wind and recoil, it was adapted to slightly deflect rounds to strike a more vital part of the enemy. Cool. Critical hit. And we got sniper rifle damage. What did it say? 30%. We got critical now on that. Headshot damage. Plus 50% headshot damage. Affects the entire squad. Adapted to slightly deflect rounds to strike a more vital part of the enemy's head. Cool. We are upgrading so much lately. Skin weave thing. Okay. Pretty awesome. Scram pulsar.
No messages for you, Commander.
Good. It's only been a few minutes. It does say here who is here. So I do need to talk to Garrus and Thane, so we're gonna go to crew quarters. Life support, Thane's in here. Gonna have another artsy dialogue thing.
Do you need something?
You mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all.
Oh, no many upgrades?
We need to have the best equipment possible to take on the collectors. You have any leads I could chase down?
I've already upgraded the Normandy's exploration probes. I have no additional suggestions.
Okay.
There's something else I'd like to talk about.
Ask.
Have a few minutes to talk?
Certainly.
Are these new? You're not a typical assassin.
If you don't mind my saying, you don't really seem like an assassin.
You've spent too much time fighting thugs who think custom-painted armor makes them professionals.
Right.
I have trained my body for this role since I was 6 years old.
Hmm. Six, huh?
You've been killing since you were six?
Of course not. I didn't make my first kill until I was 12.
Oh, well.
You were training me. I was not to be used and thrown away. I was an investment.
Investment? It's pretty cold.
You were a child, not an investment.
I've given you the wrong idea. They valued me, yes, as a resource, but also as a person. They regretted their need for me.
Hmm.
The Hanar? Excessively polite, worship the Protheans? They don't seem the type who train assassins.
Every species trains assassins. The Hanar are only unusual in that they need other species to do the killing for them. They have a strong grip and natural toxins, but have you ever seen one move quickly outside of water? Or fire a gun?
Definitely got a point there. What did your parents do?
Why did your parents agree to this?
The agreement was made under the compact. It was an honor for our family.
The compact?
We live on the Hanar homeworld because they rescued us, some of us, from extinction. We owe them our lives. That is the compact.
Huh.
What exactly are the terms of the compact?
There are many things the Hanar can't do, even with mechanical aid. They ask Drell to assist them.
Wimps.
This can't be legal. They made your whole race into slaves.
Don't insult me, Shepard. Anyone can refuse to serve. Few do. We owe our existence to the Hanar. We are proud to repay the debt.
Why was your race going extinct?
Overpopulation. That must sound trite to you. Humans developed mass effect drive before the problem became acute. Our homeworld, Rakana, had few resources. We hadn't even developed fusion power when the soil began to fail from overuse and pollution. The Hanar found us a century ago. They sent hundreds of ships, evacuated thousands of us. Billions more had to be left behind.
What's your world like now?
What's the state of Rakana now?
Do you read your philosophers? A man named Thomas Hobbes. When all the world is overcharged with inhabitants, and the last remedy of all is war, which provideth for every man by victory or death. As Rakana died around them, my people slaughtered each other for mouthfuls of water, crumbs of food.
Wow. Who do you work for now? Well, I guess me.
But you don't kill for the Hanar anymore. You're freelance. What changed?
I was asleep for a long time, yes. I paid no attention to what my body was asked to do, but then a laser dot trembles on the skull.
Huh.
One finger twitch, he dies. Then, a smell of spice on the spring wind. Sunset-colored eyes defiant in the scope. The laser dances away. My apologies. Drell slip into memory so easily.
Yeah, you know, sometimes when I talk to you, it's kind of weird. What was that?
Was that one of your assassinations?
Yes. Perhaps we can discuss it later. I've wasted too much of your time.
Hmm.
Do you need something?
I should go.
I shall return to my meditations.
Yes, you shall. Let's go talk to... Let me check over here. The AI core.
Access to the AI core is restricted.
Right, he's down here, I forgot. It's a very, like, engineering kind of place to me, seems. So I thought it was down in engineering.
Shepard. Need me for something?
Have the Cerberus crewmen given you any trouble?
I think being part of the team that took down Saren got me some points. Everyone I talked to was polite, anyway. Don't worry, Commander. We're all working together.
Have you got a minute?
Sure, just killing time anyway. I wanted to thank you again for your help with Sidonis. Whatever happens with the Collectors or the Reapers or whoever else comes after us, I know you'll get the job done.
Whoever else, huh?
You actually think we'll find something worse than Collectors or Reapers?
I like to expect the worst. There's a small chance I'll be pleasantly surprised.
Well, I'm glad you're here, Garrus.
I couldn't do this without you, Garrus.
Sure you could. Not as stylishly, of course. It's strange going into a suicide mission on a human ship. Your people don't prepare for high-risk operations the way Turians do.
Huh. What do you think our chances are?
Honestly, Garrus, what do you think our chances are?
Honestly? The Collectors killed you once, and all they did is piss you off. I can't imagine they'll stop you this time. But an unmapped area, advanced technology, and the Collectors. We're going to lose people. No way around that. Not a happy analysis, I know. Don't worry. I won't spread it around. And I'm with you regardless.
What about him in CSEC?
Do you ever regret leaving CSEC or the Turian military?
True.
Not for a minute. When it comes down to it, Shepard, I don't think I'm a very good Turian.
No?
When a good Turian hears a bad order, he follows it. He might complain, but he knows his place. I just don't see the point in staying quiet and polite. Not when the galaxy is at stake.
Turian preparations.
How do Turian crews get ready for high-risk missions?
With violence, usually. Turian ships have more operational discipline than your Alliance, but fewer personal restrictions. Our commanders run us tight, and they know we need to blow off steam. Turian ships have training rooms for exercise, combat sims, even full-contact sparring. Whatever lets people work off stress.
Full-contact sparring?
You mean Turian ships have crewmen fighting each other before a mission?
It's supervised, of course. Nobody's going to risk an injury that interferes with the mission, and it's a good way to settle grudges amicably. I remember right before one mission, we were about to hit a Batarian pirate squad. Very risky. This recon scout and I had been at each other's throats. Nerves, mostly. She suggested we settle it in the ring.
And how did it go?
I assume you took her down gently.
Actually, she and I were the top-ranked hand-to-hand specialists on the ship. I had reach, but she had flexibility. It was brutal. After 9 rounds, the judge called it a draw. There were a lot of unhappy bettors in the training room. We ended up holding a tiebreaker in her quarters. I had reach, but she had flexibility. More than one way to work off stress, I guess.
Shaking her head. Okay, this is if I want to romance Garrus, which I do not, thank you. What about Ilos?
I thought you'd be used to high-risk operations on human ships. I mean, think about trekking Saren to Ilos.
Sure, but that was quick. We raced out, landed, blew up some Geth, and saved the galaxy. This time we've got Miranda and Cerberus and that AI all telling us what we're up against. I think I preferred blind optimism.
Thanks for the talk, Garrus. I'll see you later.
Sure thing.
Sorry I didn't come on to you. I'm a faithful shepherd. So, where to next?
No messages for you, Commander.
I think next episode we will go after Tally for the Tally, recruitment thing, finally. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and enduring. Grow strong.